as society has progressed over the last century or so, we're being divorced from a relationship with nature.
Humans have an innate tendency to want to connect with nature, so we're trying to reinstill that sense of biophilia.
A lot of the collaboration is coming through Rossy's scientific research.
I study both the evolutionary history and the potential impacts of climate change on wading and coastal birds.
My art practice right now is kind of situated in a virtual space, 3D sort of space.
That was really what attracted me to this project, is working with someone to find newer ways to communicate kind of this idea that people should be caring about nature. We selected six species that we were interested in that we thought kind of represented the diversity of shorebirds. And then I get skeletal specimens, so the skeletons of these birds, and I use a three-dimensional surface scanner, so it's like a rotating table with this big kind of like lasery thing shining down on it. It looks pretty cool. And it turns around and it creates a three-dimensional mesh of the surface of the bone.
I took those three-dimensional meshes and created a 3D animation of a space that the skeletons are in. And this space describes their migratory route. You get a sense of the motion around the globe that the species travel through. We went out into the field and Rossy was able to find locations around Chicago that are similar to the natural habitats of the bird species that we're looking at for this project. Having a drone with a camera on it, that's giving us a direct perspective from literally a bird's eye view.
Something that we had toyed around with the idea of was this idea of extinction and like how to portray that visually. And what we ended up settling on is kind of this visual where the skeletons like collapse and melt on these pedestals.
A literal collapse of an object that is representative of an entire species, essentially.
Most of these birds migrate huge distances. And because of that, it means that they have to have multiple suitable habitats. In coastal systems and things like wetlands, people really want to develop property, so they're particularly at risk because of that.
This is a problem that isn't getting enough attention.
I'm very passionate about kind of engaging with the public in a way that's not like, here's all of these facts to kind of overwhelm you, but connecting with nature visually is something that everyone can do. I'm definitely existing kind of in a bubble of science people, and it was very challenging to kind of think about how to communicate what I'm trying to do through art, why my work is important.
This whole process has really opened up new ways of talking about the work that I do. So I think that that was a really interesting challenge to sort of meet. It's a really, really fantastic program. And I certainly learned a lot about the world that I didn't know about prior, I would say.
Same.
Yeah.